Exactly 1 year ago, AMD officially launched, to much acclaim, their Ryzen 3000 series processors, thanks to TSMC's excellent 7-nanometer manufacturing process and some major changes to the architecture. For first time in a very, very long time, more than 10 years, the company was able to stake a claim at having the fastest desktop processors, thanks to the 12-core Ryzen 9 3900X. Flash forward a year later, and AMD wants to recall this moment with the appearance of several new models, including the Ryzen 9 3900 XT. Currently, there are three different XT models: Ryzen 9 3900 XT, Ryzen 7 3800 XT, and Ryzen 5 3600 XT. As the name should give you a hint, these should be minor variations of the currently existing models ending with an X in the name, and they offer just a bit higher maximum turbo boost clock speed. More specifically, we have plus 100 MHz for Ryzen 9 3900 XT and Ryzen 5 3600 XT, and plus 200 MHz for 3800 XT. The TDPs and the base clock speed remain the same as in the regular X variants. However, the 3900 XT and 3800 XT lose their box coolers in the package because, according to AMD, very few users of this class of processors use them, and removing them allows them to disregard their thermal characteristics when setting up the processors, as they expect to be used with higher performance cooling solutions. The reason for this announcement is that over the past year, minor improvements in TSMC's manufacturing process have accumulated enough improvements in the yield of higher frequency chiplets to allow slightly higher clock speeds to become standard. In fact, we've already seen this in recent reviews thanks to the new Ryzen 5 3600. So essentially, AMD is just giving you the opportunity to get guaranteed new production chip at the expense of a box cooler in some of the cases. Our specific test specimen was produced in the 14th week of 2020. Finally, the official prices of the XT models remain the same as the equivalent X models, that is $499 for Ryzen 9 3900 XT, $399 for Ryzen 7 3800 XT, and $249 for Ryzen 5 3600 XT. However, how does this difference of 100 MHz maximum turbo boost frequency affect the real world clock speed? For comparison with the new Ryzen 9 3900 XT, we used an older Ryzen 9 3900X produced in the 22nd week of 2019. We checked the speeds using Hardware Info 64 to detect frequencies in applications and RTSS plus MSI Afterburner to monitor frequencies in games. The results are in the table shown, and there are about 100 to 125 MHz higher clocks against the older version. It is not something big, so you can expect 2 to 3% higher performance due to that. This is also reflected in overclock results, as we managed to get 4.25 GHz at 1.3375 volts for the all cores, that is against the 4.1 GHz at 1.35 volts for Ryzen 9 3900X, the older chip. In terms of power consumption and temperature, the difference is basically in the margin of error. So, with all that in mind, let's get to a quick testing session. As can be expected by the difference in clock speed, typically the difference in performance is about 2-3% in favor of the Ryzen 9 3900 XT, which is to say negligible. It is even smaller in games and is basically margin of error, and that is why we even have cases where the order of the processors is nominally switched. So, in conclusion, what do we say about the new processor? Yes, there are improvements in production that lead to slightly higher clocks, but the difference is just too small enough. On the other hand, AMD is not pretending there is enough for a new model number, just a small upgrade worth adding a T at the end. What I don't like, however, is the omission of box coolers in the Ryzen 9 3900 XT and Ryzen 7 3800 XT. It would have been more straightforward situation if we faced similar models with just a bit higher clocks, but now it's basically choose the one with the box cooler and just a tiny bit less clocks and probably a lower price as it's on the market for a longer time, against just a tiny bit faster new model without the box cooler. Basically, you pay for guaranteed better quality silicon, so the new XT model should only have some meaning if you plan to overclock. And even then, it is not much of a meaning as the 3900X should also have moved to newer produced chiplets. But in the end, the XT series is obvious marketing exercise by AMD to bring the conversation back to itself after the announcements of the Intel LGA 1200 platform and perhaps challenge reviewers to do fresh tests with their processors to reaffirm the possible price recommendation of older X models. But honestly, I'd rather have them announce the Renoir-based APU models for the desktop than add a T to already available processors. That's it for today. Like if you liked it, subscribe if you want more, and if you want, you can support us on Patreon. Bye!